Hey everyone, this is Andrew, and in this video I wanted to introduce my new Kontakt sample library called GS-2018. It's an analog synthesizer sample library. It comes with a main patch that combines all of the oscillators and recreates the instrument in Kontakt. It comes with a couple of more sound designed instruments, or NKSs, that you can use to get more of the raw sounds of the raw source material than if you were to recreate those sounds in Kontakt. In addition to that, there's a new kind of interface that I made, which is kind of a touch-based interface. It's called Touch. And that allows you to assign different parameters at different levels what happens when you press a note at different velocities. Also, aftertouch as well. So first, let's take a look into the main patch, which is the GS-2018 NKS. If you download the file, you will see that you get this folder here, and you have this GS-2018 NKI. That is the main patch, and you load it up. And right away you get a nice analog sound. So I'll turn off some of the effects like reverb, delay. I'll turn down the noise and saturation, the envelope depth and the vibrato depth, and the, yeah, that's it. So now I have a sound. Let me normalize these two, get the tuning back, and now we're at kind of the stock bass settings, if you will. And I want to walk you through a typical kind of sound creation for GS-2018. So you can select your oscillators. So if I do double saw, I'm going to turn them both up. Open up the filter. Turn down the resonance. If you want to go into a mono mode to recreate the original instrument, you go into this mono tab. I just use the stock Kontakt Unisono Portamento script. You turn mono mode on, you turn portamento on, you can set your time to whatever you want. There are also presets in there that are legato presets. So if I turn down the ADSR, yeah, so what I did is I got the instrument and I recorded all of its oscillators on both of its VCO channels. And believe it or not, it took me 3 tries to say that. And basically what it boils down to is on the left side, or VCO1, you have saw, pulse long, pulse short, and triangle. And on the right, or VCO2, you have saw, pulse long, pulse short, and ring modulation. And then you have the ability to change the volume, change the pan with this width knob, and change the tuning. So if I play with the width knob, you'll hear what I mean. I'm gonna turn off portamento actually. So if I turn one completely down, you'll see, make the effect more obvious. Just one knob interface that makes it easier to kind of change the stereo width. You can kind of flop which sound is on which side. You can mix different oscillators. Yeah, so the filter section, you have a standard low-pass filter with resonance, so get a high-pass filter with resonance. You have an LFO that's assignable to the filter, so if you want to activate that, you can set it to something like sine, turn up the mod depth, and also probably to make you hear it, turn down the low-pass filter, change the timing. Yeah, so I'm going to turn that down. You also have a delay and reverb sound. So if I turn this up, let's do one eighth note triplet. Turn up the repetitions. And then that's the effects section. You do have noise, which is actually recorded noise from the instrument. It's not just like a software noise. So if I turn that up, I turn up the filter to make it more obvious. That's that. You have saturation control. You have a VCF, or sorry, you have a ADSR on the filter. Turn up the envelope depth to activate it. And that's that. There also is a vibrato. You can set the rate and the depth. Now, lastly at the bottom, you'll remember this from my Neutronic instrument. Turn down the vibrato. With this, it's kind of like a sequencer, but it's also, it's basically a sequencer. It's a dual sequencer on the low-pass filter. And I found it's very cool to make these pulse-type sounds, so I can do something like this. So it's very, very effective in that regard. You can also do, you know, crazy things like this. And it just gives you a completely different sound creation tool to play with when you're making sounds on this instrument. So there are a bunch of presets. I'm still creating them at the moment, but I'll walk you through one. I'll go into the pulses section, which is where I use some of the sequencer stuff. Industrial pulses. So yeah, you pretty much get the idea. So if you want more sound examples, just go on generastudios.com at the link down below, and there'll be more demos that you can listen to and see if this instrument is for you. So in this main folder, I'm in the GS-2018 folder that you get when you download this product. And the first one you can play with, you can go to Touch, GS-2018, and you can grab this guy here and load it. And this is the Touch instrument that I mentioned. So I've set a default patch when you open it up to kind of how I like playing with it. If you play softly, the filter is low. If you see here this velocity column, I have a certain amount of velocity control going to affect the cutoff of the filter. Same with the resonance, saturation, the attack on the amp, and the VCF. Then on the aftertouch, I have it for cutoff, resonance, saturation, chorus wet, and chorus rate. And you can control those to whatever degree your heart desires. So if I play it lightly and then I'll play it louder, you'll see what I mean. So. Yeah, so that's pretty much how it worked. You can see these VU meters or VU meters going up as I play. That just is a visual reference to see how hard you're actually playing and how much aftertouch you're doing. If I make it really crazy, I can put the resonance up as well, the saturation. If I make the attack really long, it gets a cool effect in terms of kind of like a live playable ambient instrument. I play it soft, it's very filtered, it's a very long attack, and as I play it louder, it doesn't. So I can do cool things like that. which creates a very expressive instrument compared to, you know, usual Kontakt libraries, at least I thought. Some synthesizers have this kind of control. You can map the velocity and aftertouch to various parameters, but in Kontakt, I haven't seen it too much, so I thought it was cool, and I've included it in my Ambitronic Sunset library. You can also find the Genera Studios. That one has a completely different set of raw sound. This is based on the GS-2018 instrument library, so it's got the same sounds put into this. So now if I close this, not going to save the changes. If I go back to my main folder, I go to More Instruments, and then here I have four kind of like sound-designed instruments that I created, you know, on the actual synthesizer itself instead of recreating the sound in Kontakt. So I'll just open up the first one, High-Res Saw. So as you can imagine, this is a saw. So as you can imagine, this is based off of a saw wave patch. Except what I did is I cranked up the resonance until it was not self-oscillating, but that it was like super distorted and brutal. And it gets a very like saturated, over-clipping kind of sound, which is very nice. Yeah, that's that sound. It has all the same kind of parameters that you can control in the regular GS-2018. It just doesn't have the oscillators because in this case, I mapped a one set of sounds to this instrument. If I go into plucks, it's the same kind of idea as that in terms of the controls, except the raw sound is a pluck-based sound. I'm not a very skilled keyboard player, but I try to be sometimes. So it's a very cool sound. And it's cool in a way that you can't really recreate that exact sound in Kontakt. You need to do that on the raw instrument, just the way that the filters and envelopes interact in an analog synthesizer. It's a little bit different and a little more organic than something you would do in Kontakt. So that's why I included these. Next, I wanted to kind of do a vibrato type sound. Which, as you can imagine, is a square wave with some vibrato applied on the instrument. You can also add additional vibrato to it, so but the raw sound, let's get that wobble. Yeah, so let's go to the last one, which is Vintage Ring. This one is actually, it's the ring modulation setting on the synthesizer. But what I actually did is I put it through a super dirty distortion type effect. And it kind of made a cool sound, so that's why I included it. And yeah, so that's all the different instruments that are included in the GS-2018 sample library. If you want more information, click the link below and you can go to generastudios.com and you can get the breakdown of the features, the size, the preset categorization, the final preset categorization, because as I mentioned, by the time of the recording of this video, it's still a work in progress. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you check out the instrument at least, give it a thought, whether if you want to pick it up. And yeah, feel free to leave me any questions below and I will get back to you. Thanks. Bye.